So I've created this data structures library in NetBeans, and it has a collection ADT, so an abstract data type for a collection. And that just has methods for isEmpty, size, and toString. These are methods that any kind of data structure will need to implement. We always want to be able to check if our collection of our data structure is empty, find out what the size is, how many elements are in it, and be able to print it out. Now, I've also created a stack abstract data type, and this extends the collection and adds the things that are specific to a stack data structure. So we need a push, a pop, and a peak, because of course a stack data structure is LIFO, so it's last in, first out, and so we need to be able to push things on, pop them off, and peek at the top element. So we now want to actually implement the stack ADT interface. So we are going to create a new Java class, and it is going to be called ArrayStack, because it is a stack implemented with an array. So array in this case is kind of the adjective. Right, and once we get into our array stack, we are going to have to allocate or have a private member for our stack. So this is going to be private. First of all, we have to actually specify that it takes generics and that it implements the stack ADT like that. Okay. And so before I even do anything else, with just that here, we'll see that NetBeans is throwing up a sort of an error, and it says, wait a second, this is implementing something and you haven't got all the methods in here. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and say, okay, NetBeans, thanks, help me out and implement all those methods. And so by doing that, it has put all of these methods in here, except for the toString one, which I have to put in myself because it was already overridden. So public string, toString. I won't do that. I will, again, tell NetBeans to do it for me because NetBeans will make sure that it doesn't have typos. So let's have NetBeans create a toString method. There we go. Okay. So now let's put in the members that we need. So we need a private T stack. So this is our array that's going to hold the stack, and then we need the private int top to point to the top of the stack. Okay, and now we need a constructor. So let's insert a constructor, and there we go. And in our constructor, we are going to want to actually allocate this stack. So this is going to look like this. Stack equals new, or sorry, stack equals, we have to cast to a generic, and we're going to say new object, and there we go. Okay. So we are creating an array of objects and we're casting it to an array of generics and storing it in stack. And what does it say? Array dimension is missing. Oh, we haven't said how many. Okay, so let's actually create another private int init capacity, and let's make that a static. Private static int init capacity equals 50. Let's assume that initially when we create an array, we'll put 50 empty slots in it. Okay, there we go. And actually, we can actually create another array or another constructor that allows us to specify how big to create the array stack. So let's try and do that. Constructor. Int capacity. And then in this case, we're going to copy this in here, and we're going to use capacity. So it would actually make better sense to do this with init capacity. There we go. All right, so if we call the constructor and we don't give it any a size, then we're gonna call this constructor and we're gonna give it the size of 50. Okay, so now we've made our array stack and we now have to implement these other methods. So the push, the pop, the peak, is empty, and size. So let's start with the really easy one. Size is just going to be top. So we're just going to return top, because remember that our top variable is always going to be telling us how many elements there are in the stack. And also, this makes me realize that in our constructor, we need to initialize top to 0. Okay, and then our isEmpty method is also really easy. And that is going to say if top is equal to 0, then we are going to return true, and otherwise we will return false. Okay. So those two are the easy ones. They're sort of done. And then we need to do push, pop, and peak. So let's do those. So for the push, we need first to make sure that the stack is not full. And this has to do with checking the array length and checking top. So what we want to do here is say, if top is equal to stack.length, then that means that we're at capacity and we need to double our array. So let's create a method. We'll call it expand capacity. And this method doesn't exist yet, but we can have NetBeans create it for us. And that's down here. So expand capacity, in order to implement this, we are just going to use the built-in arrays. So we're going to say stack equals arrays dot copy of, and we want a stack, and our new length is going to be stack dot length times 2. So we're just going to double it. Okay. And NetBeans will do the right thing for us, and it will import java.util.arrays in order to make that method accessible. All right. So back to our push method. We now have taken care of the situation in which, you know, our array is not big enough and we've doubled it in size. And now we can go ahead and actually add the element. So what we're going to do is we're going to put that element at stack of top, because remember that top points to the next empty element, so we're just going to set that to element, and then we just have to increment top. So that's pretty straightforward. Okay, and for the peak method, we're going to jump down to that because it's similar. For peak, we are also going to have to check, we don't have to check because we're not actually pushing anything on, so we don't have to expand capacity. But what we do need to do is we need to check and make sure that it's not empty. So if is empty, then we are going to throw a new empty collection exception. Because it's possible that the user could try to peek at an element when the stack is empty, and that would be their faulty logic causing that to happen, but they might do it, and we need to tell them and give them an error that that's not a good thing and that something has gone wrong. Okay, so then we need to return the element that is at top minus 1. So return stack of top minus 1. Okay. Because this is just peak, they just want to see what it is, they don't want to remove it, so this is all that we have to do. And now for pop, we need to do the same isEmpty stuff. Okay, and then pop, we actually need to store the result temporarily. So t result equals, and we're going to get stack of top minus one. And we're going to eventually return t, because that's what we need to do. We're going to return the result. But we also need to decrement top, so top minus minus, and we need to actually set what was there to be null, just to make sure that that slot really now is empty. There we go. So now that slot no longer has the pointer to that object, but we've returned the pointer to that object, so the object isn't lost or anything like that. It's being returned as a result. Okay, so we've now implemented push, pop, peak, isEmpty, and size, and the last thing that we have to implement is the toString method. And in order to do this, we need to actually iterate through our stack. And so what I'm going to do is create a string buffer to store each element in our stack. So string buffer sb equals new string buffer. I'll just make it the empty string. And then I'll have a for loop for int I equals 0. And I'm going to go up until I equals top, less than top. And that's because I'm iterating through the elements. So once I do this, then we can actually, I want to check and make sure that an element is not null. It shouldn't be, but just to be safe, doesn't equal null. If it doesn't equal null, I'm going to tell that element to print itself. There we go. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to append that to my I'm going to append that to my string buffer. And then I'm also going to append a comma and a space just to separate each element out. Okay, so that takes care of my string method. So each element we're going to go through and we're going to print it out, comma, space, and then the next element. And then this has to go into, we're going to return this string, which is array stack, and then the string buffer, like that. Okay, so that's how we implement the array stack, and in another video I will show you how to build a test harness so that we can actually test and make sure that this is all working properly. Thanks for watching.